Hello everyone, today we'll be looking at the quick solutions to the chemistry section of All India Akash Test Series JEE Advanced 2020 Test 4A Paper 1 Code A and B. So let's start with the first section, students. So students, the first section contains 8 questions. The answer to these questions are in the form of single digit integers. Okay, so let's start with question number 21. So consider the following reaction sequence. So we have been given a reaction in which the major product P is formed. Examiner seems to be interested in the number of 6-membered rings in the product P and the number of moles of Grignard reagent that can react with 1 mole of product P. Okay. So if we try and figure out the reaction that is happening, students, in the first step, the lone pairs over oxygen will interact with the H positive. So this will convert into the oxonium ion, so OH2 plus, and then this will leave, generating a carbocation over here. Okay. Now the carbocation generated will undergo rearrangement and then there will be ring expansion in the system. Okay. So if we talk about the product which is formed after the ring expansion, students, we can draw that structure now. Okay. So there are 4-membered rings. There are OH. Okay. And then there was a carbocation over here. So this bond will migrate over here and the carbocation will be shifted at this position, students. Okay. So if we try and draw the 5-membered ring directly after expansion, so we're going to have the structure. Okay. And now due to the heating in the system, students, this is going to get deprotonated and the double bond will be formed in this position. Okay. So now if we talk about the other groups which are present, students, similar case will happen. Protonation of the OH group, it's leaving the carbocation formation and then the ring expansion. And then the deprotonation finally is going to happen all over again. And then finally we are going to get the formation of a substituted benzene. So finally we are going to obtain this structure, students. Okay, so this is the major product P which is formed. Okay, now if you talk about the number of 6-membered rings present in P, students, it is going to be 1. So the value of X comes out to be equal to 1. And if you talk about the moles of Grignard reagent that can react with 1 mole of product P is Y. So the value of Y is equal to 0, students. And since we have to report the sum of X plus Y, the answer has to be reported as 1. Okay, let us look at the next question now. Question number 22. When phenol reacts with hydrogen, so the 3 equivalent of hydrogen have been given to us. In the presence of nickel catalyst under high pressure, it forms a compound A. Okay. Further vapors of A are passed through copper gauze at temperature 573 Kelvin. A new compound B is formed. So we have to comment on some statements which are given about A and B. Okay. So let us first try and figure out the reaction, students. So we had phenol. Phenol was allowed to react with 3 equivalents of H2 in the presence of nickel catalyst at high pressure. Okay, so the benzene ring will undergo hydrogenation to give us cyclohexanol. Okay, so this is the compound A which was formed, students. Now if you talk about the reaction of cyclohexanol with copper gaze at 573 Kelvin, it is going to lead to the formation of cyclohexanone. Okay, so ketone will be formed. So this is the product B which was obtained. Now if you look at the statements which are given to us, students, option P, it says compound B can give positive Fehling's test. This is not correct, students. It is a ketone. Ketones do not give positive Fehling's test. Okay. If you talk about statement Q now, compound A is a hydrocarbon with a molar formula C6H12. This is not correct, students. It also has an OH group present. Okay. If you talk about the R option now, when compound A is oxidized using PCC, an aldehyde is produced. So aldehyde is not produced, students. The same product will be formed. So copper 573 Kelvin is also oxidizing it to the ketone. Whereas if you talk about PCC, the PCC will also carry out the exact same conversion only. So R is not correct. If you talk about statement S now, one molecule of B can react with one molecule of CH3MgBr in presence of dry ether. So this is correct, students. This cyclohexanone or the ketone which is formed can add one mole of the Grignard reagent. Okay, so statement S is correct, students. If you talk about statement T now, one mole of compound A reacts with one mole of PHMgBr in presence of dry ether. So this is also correct, students. There is an acidic hydrogen present, so there is an alcohol, and the pH negative will extract this H, and it is going to give us benzene. Okay, so statement T is also correct, students. If you talk about the statement U now, compound B is aromatic compound, this is not correct. Option V, it says that compound A is aromatic compound, this is also not correct, students. Okay, so the examiner is interested in the number of statements which are incorrect. So students, out of these given 7 statements, there are 5 statements which are not correct. So for question number 22, the answer has to be marked as 5. Let us look at the next question now. Question number 23. When benzaldehyde is reflux with alcoholic KCN, after the complete reaction, it forms a compound X. So students, this is the benzoin condensation reaction. So the compound X is benzoin. Okay, so we are going to have pH, CO, CHOH, and then we have pH. Okay. It is further given to us that when benzaldehyde reacts with ethyl 2-bromoethanoate and zinc, after acidic hydrolysis and heating, it forms a compound Y. Okay. So if we talk about the compound Y, students, so in order for the formation of Y, there is a reaction between benzaldehyde, which is PHCHO, along with the compound given to us is ethyl 2-bromoethanoate. Okay. So we have an ethanoate, and then we have an ethyl, and then we have a 2-bromo. Okay. So this is allowed to react with zinc, students. So the zinc is going to create an anion over here. So this Br will leave, and then the carbon ion will be generated over here, and then this nucleophile will attack the benzaldehyde at the carbonyl carbon. Okay, so we're going to have the formation of PHCHOH CH2COOAT in the first step, and then it is subjected to hydrolysis and heating. So students, after hydrolysis and heating, there will be two things happening. This ester group is going to get hydrolyzed, and it is going to convert into an acid, and then this beta hydroxy acid is going to get dehydrated to give us an alpha beta unsaturated acid. Okay, so there are two things happening. There is a dehydration happening from here, and then this, there is a hydrolysis of this ester as well. Okay, so finally we're going to have the formation of this compound, which is also called as cinnamic acid. So this is the compound Y which is formed, students. Now the examiner seems to be interested in the molar masses of X and Y. Okay, so if you talk about the molar mass of benzoin, it comes out to be 212, students. If you talk about the molar mass of cinnamic acid, the molecular mass of cinnamic acid comes out to be 148. Okay, so the difference comes out to be 64, and the value of M is 64. We have to report the value of M by 8. So students, the value of M when divided by 8 will give us a value equal to 8. So for question number 23, we have to mark the answer as 8. Let us look at the next question now. Question number 24. Aspartic acid is subjected to gel electrophoresis. Okay, so the structure of aspartic acid has been given to us. It is given that pKa1 is 2, pKa2 is 4, and pKa3 is 10. What will be the pH when aspartic acid shows no net migration towards any electrode? Okay, so students, the examiner seems to be interested in the isoelectronic point. So the examiner is asking about the pI. And if we look very carefully at the structure which is given to us, it is an acidic amino acid consisting of two acidic groups. So students, the pI will be given by the average of the pKa values of these two acidic groups which is present. Okay, so it will be pKa1 plus pKa2 by 2. So this comes out to be equal to 3, students. Okay, so for question number 24, we have to mark the answer as 3. Let us look at the next question now. Question number 25. Consider the following reaction. So we have been given a cyclic anhydride. Okay, it is first allowed to undergo hydrolysis to form the product P. And then the product P is first allowed to react with LiLH4, and then it is allowed to react with PCC in excess. Okay, leading to the formation of the compound Q. The number of groups which can lead to the formation of an oxime when Q is treated with hydroxylamine at pH equal to 5 is equal to. It is also given to us that hydroxylamine is present in an excess amount. Okay, so let us first try and figure out the reaction sequence, students. If this anhydride is allowed to undergo hydrolysis, it will convert into the acid. Okay, so in the first step, this will undergo hydrolysis and lead to the formation of this acid, students. Now when this is allowed to react with LiLH4, so the LiLH4 is going to reduce this acid into alcohol. Okay, so we're going to have this alcohol. Okay, and now this alcohol is further allowed to undergo oxidation using PCC. Okay, so the PCC will convert this alcohol into an aldehyde only. It will not take it all the way to the acid. So this will be the aldehyde which is formed. Okay, so this is the major product, which is Q. Okay, so now the examiner seems to be interested in the number of groups present in Q which can form an oxime upon reaction with the hydroxylamine. Okay, so we can clearly see that there are four aldehyde groups present, and all of these aldehyde groups can form an oxime upon reaction with hydroxylamine. Okay, so for question number 25, we have to mark the answer as 4. Let us look at the next question now, students. Question number 26. Find the number of reactions which are leading to the formation of correct major product. Okay, so if we talk about the reaction given in option A, so this amine is allowed to react with nitrous acid. So nitrous acid is going to convert this amine into N2 positive, and the N2 positive will leave, leading to the formation of a carbocation over here. The carbocation will then rearrange to give us the tertiary carbocation, and then finally the water molecule will attack and lead to the formation of this given tertiary alcohol, which is correctly represented. Okay, so if we try and talk about this reaction, students, we can quickly have a look at it. So in the first step, this will be converted into N2 plus. Then the N2 plus is going to leave, generating a carbocation at this position. And this carbocation is going to rearrange to form a more stable tertiary carbocation, and then water is going to attack this carbocation, leading to the formation of the tertiary butyl alcohol. Okay, so option A is correct. If we talk about option B now, so we have a quaternary amine. It is allowed to react with Ag2O moist in presence of heat. Okay, so this is the Hoffmann elimination. So we're going to get a tertiary amine, and then we're going to get an alkene. So the alkene formed is C2H4. So this is not correctly represented, students. Here we have the formation of ethane represented, which is not possible. There will be formation of ethene, so C2H4. Okay, so this is not correct, students. If you talk about option C now, in the option C we have again a primary amine which is allowed to react with NOCl. So this NOCl will generate NO positive, and then this NO positive is going to react with this primary amine to give us N2 positive. And then if we talk about the product which is formed, there will be first formation of N2 positive, and then this N2 will leave, leading to the generation of a primary carbocation. In a similar fashion, this will again rearrange to give us the secondary carbocation, and then the Cl will attack over there. Okay, so this is not correct, students. In the product, there is one carbon atom less represented. Okay, so C is also not correct. If you talk about the D now, in the D we have a secondary amine. So when the secondary amine is allowed to react with aqueous HNO2, it forms the N-nitrosoamine as represented. So this is a correct reaction, students. If you talk about reaction E now, so this is aniline, students, and aniline is allowed to react with chloroform in presence of KOH. So this leads to the formation of the isocyanide. This is the carbylamine test, students. So this is also correctly represented. Okay. And if you talk about the last reaction, the one which is given in option F, so we have a cyclic amine. It is allowed to react with two equivalents of CH3I. So in the first step, we are going to get the formation of a quaternary amine, students. And then this is allowed to react with Ag2O moist and heat. So the Hoffmann elimination will be taking place, and we're going to have the formation of this structure. Okay, so if you look at the product which is given to us in the reaction, students, we can see that this part is not correct. Okay, so students, this reaction is also not correct. So out of these given reactions, there are three reactions which are correct. So students, for question number 26, we have to mark the correct answer as 3. Let us look at the next question now. Question number 27. When phthalic acid react with excess of ammonia and then strongly heated, it forms a compound X. Okay, X on reaction with 2-chloroethanamine in presence of a base follows the nth order kinetics for nucleophilic substitution and gives a compound Y. After the hydrolysis of Y in acidic medium, phthalic acid is obtained along with compound Z. The examiner seems to be interested in the number of nitrogen atoms present in one molecule of X and Z, and he is interested in the sum of X dash, Z dash, and N, which was given above. Okay. So let us first try and figure out the reaction which is given to us, students. So we have thallic acid. So thallic acid is the ortho compound containing two COH groups. Okay, so this is allowed to react with ammonia and then it is strongly heated. So this will lead to the formation of thalamide. Okay, so we're going to have the formation of this compound. It is then allowed to react with 2-chloroethanamine. Okay, so we have CH2, CH2, NH2 and Cl. Okay, so if you look at the substrate and the reagent which is used, students, there will be an SN2 reaction. The lone pair over nitrogen is going to attack and make this chlorine group leave. Okay, so we're going to have the formation of this compound, students. Okay, so this is the compound Y which is formed. Okay, now Y is allowed to undergo hydrolysis in acidic medium, so H plus H2O. So this is going to regenerate the thallic acid which was formed. Okay, along with the liberation of the ethane diamine. Okay, so this is the compound Z, students, and this was the compound X. Okay, so if we talk about the value of N now, students, it was given that the reaction of X with the 2-chloroethanamine was of nth order. So we can clearly see that the value of N is equal to 2. This is a second order reaction. There is an SN2 reaction happening in this case. Now if you talk about the value of X dash, students, X dash is the number of nitrogen molecules present in compound X. We can see that the number of nitrogen molecules present in compound X is 1 only. So the value of X dash is equal to 1. And if you talk about the value of Z dash, students, the value of Z dash is represented as the number of nitrogen atoms present in Z. So we can see that there are 2 nitrogen atoms present in 1 molecule of Z. So the value of Z dash shall be equal to 2. The value of N was already equal to 2. So we have to report the sum of these numbers and this will come out to be equal to 5. So students, for this question, we have to mark the answer as 5. Let us look at the next question now. Let us look at question number 28 now, students. When meta-dinitrobenzene reacts with H2S in presence of ammonia, form a compound X by gaining N number of electrons, the value of N is, okay. So we have meta-dinitrobenzene is allowed to react with ammonia in presence of H2S, or H2S in presence of ammonia. Okay, so this is better written as NH4SH. Okay, so students, this reagent, it carries out selective reduction of only one of these nitro groups. Okay, so the product which is finally formed is this. Any of the two nitro groups can be converted into the amine group while the other will remain unaffected. Okay, now if we talk about the number of electrons which is involved, students, in the nitro group, we can just expand the structure. So we'll just draw the nitrogen. Okay, so if we talk about this nitrogen atom, students, we've just enlarged this part of the compound. Okay, so we can clearly see that the nitrogen present here is in a state of +3. Okay, and when we talk about this nitrogen, it is converted into an amine now. So if you talk about this part, so the nitrogen over here is present in a state of -3. So nitrogen goes from +3 to -3. It means that it must have gained 6 electrons. Okay. So students, the number of electrons which is gained by one molecule on the left is equal to 6. So students, for this question, we have to mark the answer as equal to 6.